It's me, Sweetie, and thank you for being here for another video. As you can see, I have a very tasty beverage here. It is actually in the morning. Usually I film in the afternoon because I sleep in, but today I thought it would be fun to get up early, treat myself to some coffee and some very special breakfast pastries. So I went to 85 Degrees Bakery. Now, if you have never heard of 85 Degrees Bakery, your life is about to change. This is a cafe bakery that originated in Taiwan, and it has quickly become my favorite bakery to go to. You'll usually find them in like Asian market centers, usually with like a 99 Ranch Market next door or an H Mart. So you likely have one nearby to your neighborhood. They have a wide variety of baked goods like pastries, breads, and the cutest cakes and desserts you have ever seen. And my favorite part is that they are not expensive at all. This entire bag of goodies that I got for myself today cost me $13. And for the quality that you get with their baked goods, it just can't be beat. So let's dive into this bag and I'll share with you guys some of my favorite things from 85 Degrees Bakery. So we have our first little baked good here. And something that I really like and appreciate is that during COVID, they started wrapping all their little baked goods in these individual bags. Usually they just keep them tucked away in little cabinets and you grab them with tongs, but they do individually bag them now for your safety. So this little friend that I have right here is a mango custard bun. I've only gotten this one other time before. I usually have like a few staples that I always get when I go to 85, and this is a newer one that I've started getting. The bread is so like soft and chewy, it's amazing. And then on the inside there, you can see it's kind of hollow and like the custard is down in the bottom. What I love about these desserts is they're not overly sweet. And like the custard inside is really thick. It's almost like a pudding texture. I know like in a lot of, say donuts for instance, the cream filling is like really thin and kind of watery sometimes, but this is like really thick and substantial and very high quality. Let's go for the next one here. Oh, it looks like this one got a little smushed in the bag, but that's okay. I'm sure it'll still be delicious. So this guy here, it looks like it's about the same as the last, the mango custard that I tried. I have actually never had this one before, but this is the white chocolate strawberry bun. I saw it was pink and I had to go for it. So I am very excited to try something new. I probably got crumbs all over my face, but it's fine. So usually I'm not the biggest fan of white chocolate. I find it to be a little too sweet. But this is really balanced. It's got this really yummy filling in the middle. It's like a soft pink mauve color. And it's definitely more strawberry flavored than white chocolate, which I'm a fan of. I really like this one. I would definitely get it again. And if you go and see it there, you should give it a try. So this next one is like a big classic from them. It is their premium milk bun. So this guy is shaped, it's kind of like a flower and it's got like a glaze on the top of it. It does have a cream filling. It's like a premium whipped cream filling. So I'm very excited to eat this guy. If you get this one, the glaze on the top is very sticky, so get some napkins. Yeah, as you can see, it's got the little cream filling in there. And what I love about even their sweet pastries is you can taste the butter in the bread, because the bread itself is only a little bit sweet. It's more about the filling that adds the sugar. So this bread is very like buttery and decadent. Ooh, I don't know who I was fooling wearing this cardigan. It's almost summer. And all this hair isn't helping either. Y'all are about to catch me with a shaved head for the summer. So I got this coffee from a little local place down the road from me. It's like a caramel coffee situation. Very good. I'm usually more of a tea drinker, as you guys know, but I do enjoy coffee every now and again. And whenever I do get a coffee, it has to be something with like a lot of cream, a lot of sugar, whipped cream, all the fun stuff. When you order coffee, what do you guys usually get? Let me know down below in the comments. Moving on, we have this large boy right here, and this is a sugared cream cheese Danish. It kind of feels like I'm holding a tiny pizza. So here you can see it's got some little cream cheese like circles on there and plenty of sugar, which I'm a fan of. Now, usually when I think of danishes, my mind goes to the sad grocery store bakery danishes that are usually sitting out on a table for your pathetic morning work meeting. But this is not that. Again, the bread is very buttery, and the sugar is honestly not too overpowering. It looks like there's a lot on it, but it's not overly sweet at all, and this would definitely be very satisfying for breakfast, which I'm enjoying right now. Here we have another classic from them. This is their milk pudding bun. Now, one of the things I love about 85 Degrees, besides the fact that their baked goods are incredible, is that they give a lot of their items in these little doily cups like this, so you don't have to like touch the glaze on it and get your hands sticky. So this is just a little bun. It's got this cute little swirl in the center, and the swirl is filled with a really sweet, like creamy pudding, which is why it's called a milk pudding bun, duh. And like I've said before, I really like that even though these have really like sweet, sugary names, when you eat these for breakfast, it like won't upset your stomach because they're not overly sweet. So many like breakfast items, especially in America, are just filled with sugar. And while they are delicious, they're not the best for you, especially for like a first meal of the day. So while I do enjoy the sweet side of a lot of these desserts, I don't feel as bad eating them in the morning. So here you can see all my lipstick that I'm eating off along with the bun, but the cream filling is in there. Super delicious. Just like everything else I've eaten. Eating just a couple bites of these and then putting them down is very hard, but I think my husband would be very upset with me if I just decided to devour all of these. Okay, these next two are tied for my top two favorite baked goods from 85 Degrees, but I'll go with this one next. This is the taro swirl. So taro is a really common flavor in Asian baked goods, candy, food in general. It's like a root vegetable that is sweetened, kind of like a red bean paste, and it's this really pretty lavender color. So this pastry is obviously swirled. It's called the taro swirl, and like the little swirls are really flaky and like almost caramelized. It's really cool, and the texture is nice too. And inside the bun is taro filling. It's like this really soft, almost kind of chewy filling. And again, it's a really pretty lavender color. So here's the bite. It's very hollow. I don't think you can see the filling very well, so I'll scoop some out. But I really like that these pastries are quite hollow in the middle, so it's not just like super messy and like filled with stuff that's just really overpowering, and you can really enjoy all the flavors of the baked goods together and not just like, here's a bunch of mush coming out of a pastry. Enjoy. So I just scooped out the insides of this bun, and it'll probably just pick up as like kind of white on camera. I don't know if it'll focus very well, but it's just like a soft, creamy filling, much like a red bean paste. And it does almost have like a little bit of a lumpy texture too. So it feels more natural, like they ground up the taro by hand and like left some of the chunks in there. It's really nice. And last but not least, we have my favorite bakery item from 85 Degrees. This is the coffee milk butter. So I know I've mentioned that coffee isn't the best for my stomach, but I do really love coffee flavored things. One of my favorite ice cream flavors is coffee, and that's why I love this guy so much. So this is basically like a coffee flavored pastry. The bread has like a mocha coffee flavor to it. It's got chocolate chips on the top and some cream drizzled on top of it. So it's almost like a mocha with like cream and sugar mixed in the form of a delicious pastry. Oh, and this does have a filling as well that is obviously coffee flavored, so it's perfect. I need some coffee with my coffee bread. And see, yep, there's the filling in there. Again, mostly hollow, not overly filled. It's just perfect. Okay, well, I have eaten a little bit of all the pastries as well as all of my lipstick off. Those are some of my favorite items from the bakery section at 85 Degrees. I would also really love to do a video on like all their cakes and desserts they have because they are so cute. If you have like Lolita tea parties you want to host yourself or just have something cute to eat at home on your own, 85 Degrees cakes are the way to go. Well, that's gonna do it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for spending some time with me this morning on my channel. I'm gonna go share the rest of these pastries with my husband. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!